On November 20th of 2024, the U.S. Geological Survey posted a special information statement on a volcano in the Northern Mariana Islands. They stated that the Ahyi Seamount volcano was most likely erupting and had been since early August. Although the ongoing eruption has not been directly observed, there is abundant evidence that it is ongoing at a volcano with a summit depth of 79 meters or 259 feet below sea level. In the geologic sense, this marks the Ahyi Seamount as a shallow submarine volcano. Since August 5th, intermittent 300 to 1,000-foot wide plumes of discolored teal, light blue, or yellow-tinted water have been repeatedly observed in satellite imagery. While such plumes can technically signal mere elevated unrest through increased fumarole temperatures, they generally signal that a volcanic eruption is ongoing. Second, although not confirmed, what appeared to be floating brown-colored pumice on the ocean's surface was spotted. For reference, during submarine volcanic eruptions, pumice forms when erupted high gas content lava cools quickly, trapping the gases contained within them as bubbles, creating a rock type which for a time can be slightly less dense than that of salt water and rise to and then float on the surface. This is surprising in the context of the Ahyi Seamount volcano, as this is the first time, if confirmed, that pumice has erupted from this largely basaltic to andesitic volcano. While yes, technically any type of lava can produce pumice, it generally occurs due to more silica-rich magmas such as dacite and rhyolite due to both their increased ease of trapping gas from having a high viscosity and their lower density. So, we may have some fairly uncommon basalt, basaltic andesite, or andesite composition pumice on our hands. Of course, I also want to note that per the U.S. Geological Survey, there were unconfirmed reports of pumice spotted in the area during the late 20th century, but their source was never determined. However, the lack of a piece of evidence that Ahyi Seamount was erupting was also telling. While working within normal parameters, in other words, not offline, nearby hydroacoustic sensors, which clearly detected past eruptions from the frequent explosions they produced, detected nothing. Thus, a first in 30 years of eruptions at Ahyi Seamount may have occurred. Specifically, I suggest a hypothesis that this new eruption is occurring at substantial depths of greater than 500 meters or 1,640 feet below sea level. As, if you recall, for every 10 meters or 33 feet deeper into the ocean you descend, the pressure of the water pushing down on you increases by one atmosphere. At 500 meters depth, this becomes sufficient to substantially suppress the ability for an explosive eruption to occur, and at even greater depths, at some point an explosive eruption becomes essentially impossible altogether. For example, let us suppose that the Ahyi Seamount was hypothetically erupting via a vent at 5,150 feet depth. That would equate to 155.5 atmospheres of pressure. As a result of what is likely an ongoing volcanic eruption, the U.S. Geological Survey raised the alert level of Ahyi Seamount from white or unassigned to yellow on November 20th of 2024. While non-official, I suggest that all ships avoid going within 10 miles or 16.1 kilometers of Ahyi's summit due to the potential of both shallow submarine explosive activity and the density of water unexpectedly being lowered above a rising gas plume. However, despite the fact that the Northern Mariana Islands contain 23 active or potentially active volcanoes, 10 of which have erupted since 1900, the current eruption of the Ahyi Seamount is almost completely harmless. The closest populated settlement to this volcano is a whopping 360 miles to the south, so it should come as no surprise that among all 161 United States volcanoes, Ahyi Seamount is ranked with a single lowest threat score among them with a score of 0. So, while scientifically interesting, this eruption should be harmless. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.